It's me. I wanted to show you guys my witchy altar space today, including also just this whole corner. This whole room is kind of my spiritual room, but it's a big mess right now, so I'm gonna show you my like altar corner, kind of where I keep my books, all my witchy supplies, where I do my meditation, my tarot stuff, everything like that, and where I keep my things. So yeah, I thought I would just jump in and show you. So we'll start with this wall right here. I guess we'll start over here. This is a poster that I just put on my closet door, and this I got in an astrology book that I got, and I thought it was kind of cute. So it's there. This tarot readings sign I found on clearance at Michael's during Halloween time, and so thought it was really cute. I thought it fit my vibe, so I got it. And this mirror was a mirror I've had for a very long time, and for my wedding I put "it was in the cards" on it, and then I wanted to reuse it here because I thought it was very cute. Then I have my little, I don't know, tapestry from Goddess Provisions a couple months back. This is a little broom that my husband found for me at a little like flea market. I don't think it is technically a broom, but I use it as like my Wiccan broom. And then I have some fake tea light candles. This is, let me get down here. This is my little apothecary shelf. I keep most of my herbs and essential oils in here. That's just a goddess painting that I made. So let me open this. I don't want things to fall. Okay. I've had this shelf for a very long time. And that's like a big thing. All my things are either like I've had them or like I got them at a flea market or something. But I try to keep it pretty cheap. I do need to dust that. That looks dirty. But I keep my herbs in here, essential oils. I have elderberry. This is my essential oil I got from my Lunarly box. Rosemary, lavender, white sage, lavender. I have some eucalyptus leaves. Cute little camel, totem animal I got. I think this is whorehound, just like leftover. This is a little baby Palo Santo that was sent to me. This is something I got in my Goddess Provisions box. It's called Yin Moon. Sorry, it's not focusing. It's just like an inhaler type of thing of herbs and stuff for, what does it say? I don't even know. Stimulating inhaler. That's cool. Frankincense, vervain, loose white sage, sandalwood, and bay leaf. So those are just like some of my herbs that I have on hand. Just think this is a cute little like apothecary shelf. I don't know, it's just really nice. It's really cute and it fits all my stuff very well. I also have, this is my little like card. I have a whole wall of cards when I get them from like Goddess Provisions and Witchy One of like the artwork. And I just kind of like to keep them there because it kind of sets me in the mood for like what the box was, and I usually try to take like the box theme and like use it as kind of a, I don't know, like a topic for how I can develop more. So this was the Beyond fuck, I can't talk today. This was the Beyond Lemuria box from Goddess Provisions. I have my oracle cards here, and I did a whole lot of past life stuff this month, and a whole lot of like, I don't know, just trying to deep dive into my past life regression on my own, which has been really nice and beneficial. So this bad boy, let me scoot back. I'm sitting on my meditation cushion, which I'll talk about later, but this is my altar. This is like my basic altar space. This is where I try to do all my tarot readings. A lot of times I'm just tired and I end up doing them just in bed or something, and that's fine too. But this is the area that I like to designate as my sacred space. And a lot of people think that, a lot of people don't show their sacred space on, I don't know, like they don't post it. I don't see an issue. I have lots of like spiritual protectors, so I'm not like worried about that or anything. And this was just my certain setup for Austera and Spring Equinox. So kind of the balancing, you can kind of see I have a theme in this. So the left side, which usually left represents the feminine, is like my flowy, my moon water over here. A lot of my more intuition products are over here. Lots of white. I have my really pretty photo shoot picture I did, like all in white, very Lana Del Rey style, but lots of just like beauty and feminine qualities over here. And then the right side I have my masculine qualities. So I have my athame, my cauldron, lots of like protective stones, some certain little tokens of mine, and then I have my sexy little photo shoot that I did, my boudoir photo shoot back a year or two ago. And then in the middle I have my singing bowl. Back here I have some more apothecary stuff, some more lavender, whorehound, and marigold. A lot of other little herbs back there. I have my bell, which was actually a family heirloom, anointing oil. I have a feather that actually found. Keep that with me because it makes me feel good. And then my friend Christian drew me this Queen of Wands little thing for my birthday, and I thought it was so beautiful, and so I just wanted to keep that with me. So on the left side, like I said, if I'm super shaky, I'm doing this handheld, so I'm sorry. I have my ritual water. This is super cool. I got this from my Goddess Provisions box, and it has a compartment for quartz and amethyst. No, I think it's quartz and rose quartz. Yeah, at the very bottom. And so I've been making my moon water in here recently. Usually I was actually like reusing some old pretty wine bottles so I could make big ones, but all my jars and stuff are down here. This is where I would pick from when I make my moon water or whatever water I'm choosing to make. But I have just really been vibing that, and I've actually been looking into getting a water bottle or something that has like a place for crystals, but then I got this and I was like, man, this is just so cute. I love that. And it's not very big. I think it's 7 ounces, but then, I mean, it's moon water, so you can put it in your water, you can put it in your bath. You know, and you can kind of just use it within everything. I have a little crystal grid over here with just some crystals on it. I'm not really big into crystal grids right now. Haven't really learned much about it, so I kind of just put some crystals on there. I've got a handful of them just hanging out. I have two of my current favorite oracle decks, my Isis Wisdom. Isis is one of my deities. And Beyond Memoria, Oracle cards, like I said before, those are ones that I've gotten that are pretty new, and I've been enjoying them, so they just feel very new and special to me, so I'm keeping them pretty out. I'll show you where I keep the rest of my Oracle and Tarot cards, but that's those. And then I have my little jar of aquamarine. Maybe that's turquoise. I should probably... Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is turquoise. Just kidding. this is a candle my friend Maddie made for me. I've been lighting that. My Isis bracelet. This is cool. I got this in my Goddess Provisions box recently, and it holds your tarot card. So I've been using that here and there. And then I have my sage and my Palo Santo. And then peach moonstone. My little selenite wand. I like this one a whole lot. I really like selenite wands, so that's really nice to have on hand. I think this is my rose. I got some old rose petals and put them in there. This is where I keep my salt in this cute little, this is really nice. I actually found this a couple years ago at a garage sale, and I just think it's really, really pretty. And yeah, that's basically why I have most things, is because they speak to me on a beauty level. and that's on being ruled by Venus. Every day when I do my tarot, I take my singing bowl, I put it in my lap. Do you guys like my socks? Thank you. I put my singing bowl in my lap so that I can use that, and then I use this little dish to lay out my 3-card spread, because every morning I do a 3-card spread. I do either a mind, body, spirit, or energy of the day, focus on avoid. That's been kind of my go-to daily spread, just so that I can make sure that I'm staying in the swing of things. But yeah, that's what I do there. And then when I'm done, I put my singing bowl back. I like to keep this on there, and it looks pretty nice and cute, hanging out right in the middle. And on the right side, I have my Archangel Michael cones. This is a cute little box that my mom gave me. I have some gold coins in there for sentimentality, and then my pendulums. I also have citrine, obsidian, and my tiger's eye. I have 2 keys, one on each side. I have a sentimental ring, my cauldron, which has some Palo Santo in it right now, my athame. I have this, I can't remember what this is called. These ladies in Africa made them, and they're at my fair trade store. It's this, I think it's soapstone, I think is what it is. I think it's a painted soapstone. And it just felt very similar feeling to palm stones, just that very smooth, nice calming effect, and I just thought it looked really pretty. And my salt lamp that's not plugged in right now. So that's the basics of the top of my altar. I did get this shelving unit from Walmart a couple years ago. It's like $30, I think. I think it's meant to be standing up, but I like being on the floor. I just feel more connected. So if you guys are wanting to do like a balance type of thing, I hope this gives you some ideas. Obviously we're going into Beltane here soon, so altars will probably be changing. I'll probably be spicing mine up a bit. Oh, I got this altar cloth from the Uncommon Witch on Etsy. She sent this to me, and I'll link that below if you guys want. Like I said, most of these, obviously the herbs I'm getting at my like local store. Athame I got at my local store, cauldron. Singing bowl I got at my local store. So yeah, that's kind of where all that's from. And so this first little section, I know it looks not organized, I promise it actually is. So that's my intention journal I got from Lunarly. Have a cord for future, I actually had this for my class where I was learning how to do like knots and stuff, but then I was like, ooh, keep that for knot magic. I have my future wand. This is my alder stick, my birth tree's alder, and I want to make my wand here soon, but haven't got to that. I have another heirloom bell back there because that must just be a Swedish thing. They just give us a ton of bells. And then I have all my like mesh bags and stuff. I know it's hard for you to see right now, but lots of incense, my cedar stick, my tongs, my charcoal blocks. This is like supplies. So if I'm like about to do a spell, I might come in here, grab my tongs, my charcoal blocks, my mortar and pestle, whatever I need. I like him a lot. He's really nice. I don't use him a whole ton. Most things I just throw in my cauldron and light them on fire, and that's on being an Aries. But I do want to use my mortar and pestle more. This is my candle drawer. I just have all my candles in here, my lighter, my candle snuffer, and yeah, just all my candle supplies. And then this one is just like my jar cabinet where I keep my jars. So yeah, the bottom stuff is a lot more supplies, and I think like what I would prefer is to have a drape that could come over because it is kind of messy, and this is clean. Like I did clean this recently, so. But yeah, so the top part's a lot more of like what's going on rather than like just this is where I reach for my stuff. And so over here, so it's just like a mirror. I mean, it's not really important. And then I have a thing that says spooky from a Halloween shop. This is my bookshelf that you guys see in all my videos because I film in front of it. And on top here, I have books that I've bought recently that I need to read. And those are things that I'm very excited to read. And this, these bookends, my, my in-laws bought these for me for my birthday. They're purple agate, and they're beautiful, and I love them so much. I have some fake candles over here because I'm scared of, like, forgetting to leave. I don't know, especially when I film, like, I don't want to, like, flip my hair and light my hair on fire. I have another little smoke stick. I have this little aura cleansing spray that I like to use when I'm cleansing my aura. This is my little ocean jasper, which is like absolutely just gorgeous. I wish that would focus. Okay, look, how pretty is that? I got this in my witchy one box and I'm obsessed. It's like actually so pretty. And then over here I have another purple agate because I was like, oh my god, they can be friends. Serpentine. Oh, and I just got this in my witchy one box and I can't remember what it's called. It's something jasper. Brecciated jasper? Brecciated jasper. And this is just a quartz cluster. And then my little, this was like an amethyst candle and I lit it and it went cool. So I love that. And here is just more books that I've read, books that I'm reading. I keep my tarot journal in here. I don't want to peek anything, but I don't want to tell you my secrets, but that's my tarot journal. And then this shelf, this is why I'm including this. This shelf is where I keep my oracle decks and whatnot. Let me turn up the brightness so you guys can see. So over here, these are my books, these are my reference books, things that go to specific decks and whatnot, just because, like, obviously you want to be able to reference them. And then I have, like, their boxes, I have some more cedar here, I have my rune stones here, and then I have another, well, this is my pendulum board, which I don't use too often, but I do have him. This is a little, like, container I got on Wish, because I was like, let me try witchy things, and I did not like it. It's very small, it fits those oracle cards, but it doesn't let them come out, so it's gonna be fun to bring them back out. I have like more journals and stuff. This is my last year's planner, one of my meditation journals, and this is another tarot journal, and then just some more books over there, a lotion, and then some more essential oils, and then I have each of my decks in like their respective bags, so. And these bags are from The Uncommon Witch as well. So this is really pretty. You guys, I'll link that unboxing video because she sent me a lot of really cool stuff. And so I have my two tarots, which is my universal weight. And then the one, it's this brand. It's the Secrets of the Tarot brand. Those are my two tarot decks. I have my Practical Witch's Spell deck. I have my Enlightenment deck. And that is my Zend Out Ritual Oracle deck. So yeah. Oh, and I totally forgot to mention, my meditation pillow is actually really janky. It's just two pillows. And then this blanket I got from LadyScorpio.com that I will link. I would like to get a real meditation pillow, but they're expensive. So join my Patreon if you want to help me get one. And then we'll see. You'll be the first to know. That's all, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Maybe this inspired you for your altar, or maybe you're just curious about what a witch's altar looks like. Either way, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!